I know it's probably the last person you wanted to see tonight, or today, or whatever time you reach for the dial. But oh my gosh, am I looking forward to not being here on this earth as a human? Am I looking forward to that release? As a human female, as a beauty byproduct human being, I guess. Yes, I am looking forward to it, because I can't adapt, I can't fit in, I can't acquire, I cannot mold, I cannot satisfy, satiate the general population. I just cannot, you know. The older I get, I cannot. I mean, my father, who's 80 years old, looks better than I do. He looks like younger than me sometimes. I fail. Don't you get it? I fail. Thusly, oh my God, the world will be happier when I am gone. That's the advertising machine. The advertising machine does not want. I don't care. You can send me ARP magazines till you're blue in the face. It's very difficult to be like, yeah, that's way cool, you know? And, well, no, I guess I don't satisfy the ARP model. I don't think I could be an ARP model. You know, I don't qualify. I don't think I'm beautiful enough. On the scale of 0 ARP model to 10, I don't make it. I'm not even an ARP model cover girl. It's that bad. And yet I have this machine so I can torture you all, force you to look at me, those who have to. I don't know who you are, but you're forced to, perhaps. Yeah. So it is a release. Death is a release for many of us. Aging women, it'll be a huge release. What a drag. What a drag. The keep-up, the makeup, the constant insinuations of you're looking older. You know, you don't qualify in that group anymore. No. And not that outfit, and not that bikini, or not this. And no, never those men. And no, just limits and more limits and more limits. I'm not. It's like the ego. It's like you can look at it like this big ego. What was the guy? One dude out there, he was saying, remove the ego. And that's a funny one. That is done automatically. That's happening every day. It's like the ego deterioration model. You know, look at this big, big circle thing with all these holes that just get riddled and poked through, you know, the longer you live. And as you try, you know, try to maintain some kind of, what is it, humor? Go, well, I'm sorry I look this way, it's just tough. I am terribly sorry I did not fit the qualifications. And there goes another whole riddle. And then there's another whole riddle over there. And it's like, I'm getting tired of making the clown of myself. And there's another whole riddle. And this circle, and like, oh my God, my husband is gone. There's another whole riddle. It just, oh my God, I cannot believe this. You know, even my recorded video machine is in this ghastly, you only fit the qualifications of being in this ghastly fade out, you know, whole riddle. Yeah, she's all trying to tell me to just jump off a cliff already, you know. Just jump. We're tired of you. We don't need you. We don't want you. You're useless. A woman is useless unless she is doing, you know. What is a woman doing in her 50 years? What is she doing? You know, is she supplying something for some people? What is she doing? Oh my gosh, maybe I'm not doing enough, you know? Not doing enough. Just today I was told, I am not a caregiver, I'm not a caretaker, I'm not helper, I'm not any of those things, you know. My father's completely independent, and I do not qualify. So, you know, what's the deal? I am not even that. I'm not even helping him. So, who and what am I doing in this life? What am I doing? Another whole riddle, because I will never ever make that person happy. I already know that. Because he will run with that mantra his whole life. Of independence. Total independence. Oh my gosh. So, what am I good at? I thought I was good at being married. I thought I was good at raising the ducks and the chickens. I thought I was good at living in the countryside with my animals and supplying humor to the day. I thought I was good at all of those things. I thought I was good at being an artist. And then, well, everything just starts to fade and frizzle and get whole punctuated again into that ego. And I'm like, well, this is just the fall of Teresa, isn't it? It's the fallout of her. It's the end of her. And maybe that's all this channel is. We'll just watch the end of her. It's so sad, really. You know, when I think about all of these kings, I'm doing all this genealogy. You know, some of them really had interesting lives, and others didn't. Like this one, you know, he was 9 years old, and he became king. And how interesting. You had to be king when you're 9 years old, King of England. It's very fascinating. And in his life, he became a homebody. After wars were going on, he became a homebody and just built onto his castles. He didn't really do much else. He just wanted to build. You know? So he was just quiet after all. Mr. 9 year old. I don't know what he was. Henry the Third? I think he was a real young one. Henry the Third. I think many of you actually do come from Henry the Third. But, oh my gosh, yeah. How does that have to do with anything? Well, I guess he had his position and he had his place. He was born into it and he was supplied. So he had the money. He could do the building on his castles. You know, he could make the extensions. And maybe it didn't matter what he looked like, you know. Maybe he didn't have to play the pony show. It didn't matter that he was beautiful or not. It just didn't matter. He was 9 years old and he was king. And I know how it is in this life, you know. Oh no, she doesn't qualify. She didn't qualify on the beauty scale to be Queen of France. You know, I've seen the way they are there. They are so, like, tragically manipulated by vanity that's where their socialism is, isn't it? It's just a manipulation by vanity. And so a king there, a queen there, well, is only ever popular in the vain eyes of the magazines, the vain eyes of the cell. So yeah. Anyway, I'm having tough here with my opera tonight. It's making me sound like all these recordings are just nasalizing me when I'm not nasal. And it's really drama, terrible. I don't know, all of these things are depressing me, and they're just more holes into that ego. Even this Ubuntu machine is a hole to my ego. Will I be relieved when I'm dead? Will I be relieved? Yes. I've told my father this. I've told my husband this. I will be relieved when I'm dead because life is a terrible, terrible bunch of work. It's a bunch of work and it's a bunch of fight. You know, you have to fight the people who kill animals just for no reason. We have to fight people who destroy good and in place of their evil. You know, it's just a constant fight all the time. I'm just tired of it. And so what are we going to end up with in the end of the day? We're just all these little clumps of cremations, you know. Well, she tried her whole life to be the good cremation pile. So there's my little pile of salts or whatever, of good. Maybe, hopefully I get 70% of good in that pile at least, of my life doings, to overhear this bad person of their 100% of evils while they were done in their cremation pile, while they're on this earth. And so how is this going to end up, you know? How many piles of, like, my cremations to make good soil again, to make up for these bad, total assholes that are walking this planet? You know, how many goods, you know? I mean, we're just going to make an ugly, evil, metal ball if we do not have more of these goods. And it can't be fake goods either. You can't just fake it away and say, this is life and we're all fake, 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 because it's even going to show up in your cremation pile. You're just a bunch of fake dust in there. So how do you fight the bunch of jerks in those piles? You know, when they're souring the planet for the future, when they're damaging it for the all eternity, how do you stop them from destroying the world in the future? Souring our earth, souring our planet. Meanwhile, I'm sitting here trying to fight my own stupid ego war. And they're piles of mean, evil, dastardly, atrocious, vile, malicious human beings is becoming our earth, is becoming our soil. I mean, what's the cleansing there after they're dead? What's the cleansing? They're still here. They're still here, and they're nasty salts. They're nasty. My beautiful dog Rudy, for example, when I cremated him, he was a beautiful bunch of red dust. I am not kidding. He turned into be a beautiful pile of red dust. Red dust that probably to this day wants to run away with the wind. Red dust that has its own agenda. That's its own independence. Like, what? Oh, it's a tough one too. It was tough to collect it and try to, like, it wanted to get into the soil and go over here and go over there. It wanted to filter away. It did not want to be collected by me even. So it had like its own plan. Have you ever tried to collect red cremation dust? You would know what I'm talking about. And it was all his hair, all his fur, and maybe it was even in his bones, but it all created that really beautiful hues, really beautiful hues that you can imagine that a potter would take and mix in with a glaze or something, you know, from the past. Gorgeous, just gorgeous hue. And I did not get that from my other dogs. I didn't get that. So he carried a special color. Anyway, so yeah. Anyway, so I'm just like, yeah, so the ego fight, you know, the beauty woman fail, the holes in the ego, and then I'm taking this into my cremation pile. I'm taking this into my cremation pile as a lesser. And then they have that adage, only the good die young. Well, certain things they take with themselves as they die. Yeah, maybe they don't have to go through the age process. They don't have to go through the deterioration of the ego and vanity as much. They don't have to go through that. So yeah, maybe their cremation pile is gonna miss those. It's gonna not have that. But then there's the learn. There's always the learn in that pile, isn't there? The older you are, there's the learn. Hopefully not the only Alzheimer in it. Hopefully it's the learn pile. You know, wouldn't that be nice to just be an old person who dies, who doesn't have the Alzheimer, who is just an old person who's wise and dies? Wouldn't that be a neat cremation pile to have? Something to aspire to, isn't it? Well, anyway, these other ones that are hurting the world, I don't know. Anyway, it's always the fight of good and evil, isn't it? It's nothing to do with a church. It's nothing to do with a religion. It's just the fight of good and evil. You treat things badly, you end up on the evil side. You treat things good, you end up on the good side. It's very simple. Very simple. One is nourishing, nurturing, and sustaining. The other is a depletion. The other is a destroy. A wash away, a hurt. An agony, an acid. So, anyway. That's it for tonight. I'm tired.